want to talk to you today about stewardship. And a steward is one who manages the property that belongs to somebody else. Property that belongs to somebody else. We manage it. We manage it. As stewards, the Bible says we should be faithful stewards. And I'll get to that in a few moments. But faithful stewards. Managing property that belongs to somebody else. You say, well, what is that property? That house you live in? Those clothes upon your back? The shoes upon your feet? They're not yours. They just borrowed. Somebody else might wear my shoes before tomorrow comes or before this afternoon. Depends on if Cheryl gives them to the Goodwill or whatever. You know? The fact is, none of the things that we possess is our own. It belongs to someone else. And it belongs to the one who blessed us with it and loaned it to us, is God. God, would you agree with me? That God is the ultimate one who blesses us with the things that we do have. He's blessed us. And he's given it to us to manage it for him and make our life a little more pleasing. I'm glad that he gave me an automobile to drive. And I'm glad that old GMC had some heat on it this morning. Aren't you? I didn't have to walk in the cold. I didn't have to come over to the house of God in the cold because I had a heat in that truck. And that was a blessing from God. That was a blessing from God. I'm glad he gave us a building that we can come in and that it's nice and toasty in here. And nice and toasty. I don't see none of you. It's freezing. But you're comfortable, aren't you? Comfortable. God blessed us with that. God blessed us with that. But God says, I want you to manage the property that I loan to you. I want you to manage. I want you to manage it well. I want you to be blessed. I want you to prosper above all. So he said, if you love me, you'll do those things. If you love me, you'll keep my commandments. If you love me, you'll do what I instructed you to do. But, that's that word, but. But, sometimes we want to do our own thing, don't we? We won't put God on the shelf and do what we want to do. And James tells us that every man is tempted when he is drawn away by his own lust and is enticed. Enticed. That means the devil dangles a little temptation in front of you. Are you going to go for it? Or are you going to turn away from it? If you love me, Jesus said, you'll keep my commandments. If you love me, you won't be chasing the things of the world. If you love me, you won't go after the bait that the devil is dangling in front of you. If you love me. But sometimes, you know, that bait is looking mighty good. We want to take it. Because the devil, he'll make it look appealing to your eyes, the lust of the eyes, the lust of the flesh, and most of all, that pride of life. So, oftentimes we miss God's blessing by mismanaging the things God has placed in our life. In the book of Malachi this morning, in chapter 3, the children of Israel had a problem going after the bait that the devil set in front of them. He enticed them with things, and they went after it instead of following God's instruction. So after that, they realized they weren't managing God's property well. So God said this to him. He says, will a man rob God? You have robbed me, he said. He answered the question himself. You have robbed me. But he said, you're going to say, wherein have we robbed thee? He says, in tithes and offerings. And then he noticed in verse 9, he said, you are cursed with a curse, for you have robbed me, even this whole nation. He says, bring all the tithes into the storehouse, that there may be meat in my house, And prove me now herewith, saith the Lord of hosts, if I will not open the windows of heaven and pour out a blessing that thou shalt not be room enough to receive it. In other words, he's saying, if you'll do what I've instructed you to do, if you'll manage my property well, I will open the windows of heaven and do what? Bless you. I will pour out a blessing that there won't be room enough to receive it. In other words, he'll give you more than you actually need. He'll give you more than you actually need. But somehow or another, we don't take God at his word, and we'll just do our thing, and we'll rob from God our time, our talent, our treasure, and our testimony. We'll rob from God. In the beginning, we can see this and how it played out. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. Right? He created the heavens and the earth, the Bible tells us in Genesis 1. And then in Genesis 2, the Lord God formed man out of the dust of the ground and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life. And man became a living soul. So God created this wonderful world, but he needed a steward who would manage it for him, so he created a man. A man, and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life. And he became a living soul. And the Lord planted a garden eastward in Eden, and there he put the man whom he had formed. And out of the ground God made, And out of the ground made the Lord God to grow every tree that is pleasant to the sight and good for food, the tree of life also in the midst of God, and the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. Then if we move down to verse 15 in chapter 2, we see, and the Lord God took the man and put him in the Garden of Eden to dress it and to keep it, to be a steward of it. And the Lord commanded the man, saying, of every tree of the garden thou mayest freely eat, but of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, thou shalt not eat of it. For in the day that thou shalt eat of it, thou shalt surely, what? Die. Let's consider this story this morning. The Garden of Eden. Man, that's a good golden, delicious apple. Fresh from Morris Orchard. Yesterday. God said, look, all of this that I've created is yours. Isn't it beautiful? Look at that nice home, that nice car. It's yours. Just manage it for me. You can live in it. You can be happy. You can raise your children, your grandchildren. But don't put that before me. Don't put those things. Don't even put your wife or your children or your grandchildren in front of me. Serve me, do what I say, I will bless you with all, look, gosh, look at that, Ed, more. I will give you more. If you'll just obey me. Oh, goodness, man, I got all kind of apples up here now. Just obey me, it's all yours. How would you like a vacation to Hawaii? Just be obedient to me, I'll make it happen. And sure enough, he did. Sure enough, he did. Oh, just be obedient to me. I'll bless you. With that Harley Davidson that you've been wanting. I'll bless you with that fishing boat you've been wanting. Yeah, just honor me. Just do what I tell you to do. Honor me. It's all yours. Make your life more pleasant. But honor me and serve me. Stay away from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. Stay away from Satan's temptations. Stay away from the things that pull you from all of these blessings. All of these blessings. all of these things I want to give you. Stay away. Don't take this one, because the day that you eat of it, you shall surely die. Now, I don't know about you, but I think that's pretty good odds right there, verses 1, don't you? But, you know, the devil will come along and say, you know, man, you got that house, you got that car, you got that boat, you got that Harley, you got that Mustang or whatever you want, you got that new kitchen, ladies, you got that new bedroom, you got that rug that you've been wanting, and you got all of this, but there's one left. I want. And all I got is this $10 left. Why can't I use it? The devil said, go ahead. Take it from God. Take it. You can use it better than he can. Take it. And then all of a sudden we start biting from this. I was going to eat this in front of you, but I figured that wouldn't be polite. And we take it. Well, I got to do this. My electric bill's coming due, so I got to do this. You didn't plan? Hello? But you consumed but didn't plan for the future for that electric bill? Went sky high this month, didn't you? Went sky high. You didn't plan? But now you want to take from God to pay that? So forth. You say, well, what does this got to do with all of anything? It has to do with a whole lot. Because God said, if you rob me, he said, will a man rob God? He said, yes, in tithes and offering. We see God's, and he don't give us 90, but we misused it. We mismanaged. And now we want to bite from his apple. And we bite it all the way down to the core, and we want to give God the core. Ain't no good... Hey, ain't no more good after it gets to the core, is it? The good stuff's gone. The good stuff's gone. God wants our best. He don't want what's left. He wants what's first. And we have to realize that in serving God, we must give God our very, very best. Remember, he owns it all in the first place. He has just loaned it to us, amen, to make our life a little more pleasant. He don't want us to be consumed with the things of this world, but he wants us to be consumed with eternal things. And boy, I tell you what, when you get your focus where it needs to be, God will bless you beyond measure. He will bless you beyond measure. You cannot, amen, outgive God. You cannot outgive God. I mean, he keeps on adding to you. And sometimes, you know, he'll give you what you want. Instead of what you need, he'll give you your dreams. I got some more in this bag if I can ever get it open. Yeah, because he wants to bless us. Long as we are obedient, he'll give us some of his stuff. Amen? We don't have to take from him. He'll give it to us. I got three more and I ain't going to pull them out. Yeah, he'll give it. Boy, I think that's pretty good odds, what you think? Pretty good odds. So, first thing God wants us to remember, as a steward, it all belongs to him in the first place. It all belongs to him in the first place. He wants us to be faithful over the little things. And he'll bless us with the rest. Be faithful. You remember a story over in the book of Mark in chapter 12 about the widow's mite? Jesus was watching folks bring treasures in the temple. And a little woman, she dropped just a little mite into the bucket. He said she's given more than all of these. Some was given big donations. But the fact she gave from the heart for what she had. God doesn't require to give more than what you have, what he has blessed you with. You be faithful over little, he'll bless you with a great deal. But if you can't be obedient with a little, how can he trust you with bigger deal. Hello? Be faithful over the little. She was faithful. She went away more blessed than the rest. She went away, why? Because she was faithful with the little. So God wants to realize as a steward, we must realize it all belongs to Him. He wants us to be faithful with the little that He has blessed us with. And He can entrust us with the little. He can entrust us with the bigger things in life. And He wants us, most of all, to be consistent. Be consistent. Don't eat it. And then give Him the core. Give Him the first fruit. Give Him the 10 right off the top of your time, your talent, your treasure, and your testimony. Do we give God 10% of our time? Do we give Him 10% of our time? Hours He gives us in a day, right? Do we give Him 10% of that? What's 10% of that? 2 hours and 40 minutes? Somewhere in there? Do we get up and give Him that amount of time? Do we get in His Word? He said, well, I can't. Boy, I sleep till the right time to go to work. By the time I get ready, I ain't got time to pray. I ain't got time to read. Well, need to get up a little earlier, don't I? One of our founding fathers says, early to bed, early to rise, makes a man healthy, wealthy, and wise. Especially if that man or woman takes the time that God has allotted to you and give Him 10% of it. We don't mind watching a 2.5 to 3 hour movie, do we? Y'all getting quiet on me. Come on. We got to be good stewards of our time. Do we give God 2 hours and 40 minutes in the day? We bite it, don't we? We take God's time. We take God's time. Oh, what about our talents? All of us in here got at least one talent. Do we use the talent that God has given to us? Do we give Him 10% of that talent? Relative to you can do something with your hands, or rather you can do something with your mouth. Some of you are good with the mouth, amen. But do we use it for God's glory? Do we give Him 10% of it, of our talents? We could use it to help our neighbor, friends. And some of you got great talent that you've been hiding, and God wants you to bring it out. You've been biting on that apple for too long. He wants the complete apple, not the core. Hello? And He has blessed you. Use it for God's glory. Use it for God's glory. And some of you have. You stepped out tremendously. But there's more that needs to step out. And give God what's due to Him so He can bless you with all of this. Looks pretty good, doesn't it, Bruce? I mean, boy, wouldn't that be good in an apple pie and some ice cream on it? We got to do what God tells us to do. We're giving Him 10% of our time, 10% of our talent. Oh, what about that treasure? He said, bring it into the storehouse that may be meat. You want to do a more broader ministry? Then you have to give to God's work. You have to give to God's work. Everything that we give to God, He multiplies it. If it's given in the right spirit, He'll multiply it. And then you have, I think I'm on the third T, right? And the fourth T is a great testimony for God. Seeing what God has done. I've heard testimony when I was growing up of people who put this into practice that was great stewards. How many remember the Great Depression? Don't not too many in here remember that. But some of the older people that I grew up with went through that. And I can hear one lady right now giving a testimony how God brought her through. She said, we never lacked. And she had a tremendous house full of kids. We never lacked food because we always gave to God first. Matter of fact, through the tough times, she would testify that even through the toughest times of that Great Depression here in America, she was able to feed her family and to help her neighbors, feed them at times. That's God's blessing upon obedient servant. And God will bless you beyond measure if you honor him with your time, your talent, your treasure, that you can have that great testimony to share with others. When the preacher says, anybody got a testimony for the Lord? You won't sit there, but you'll be glad to stand up and say, I got one. Faithful servants, amen, will always stand and give God, amen, what's due to him. Give God. And you know, a great steward plans for the future. Look, folks, amen. God says, let's plan for the future. Don't spend all you got today. Plan for the future. I blessed you with 90. Use it wisely. Plan for the future. Old man told me, plan for a rainy day. Because emergencies happen, don't it? You might run over a nail in the road. You have to get a new tire. If you don't spend all your 90, and the only thing you got left is God, you're going to take from God to fix that tire? He said, you should have planned with the 90 for that day. Plan. Plan for the future. And this one gets it all. A lot of times we don't plan for the future of our eternal home either, do we? We use up that time that God allotted us. We use it for our selfish desires. Our talent goes with that as well. Our treasure, our testimony, it all goes down the tubes with that because we're so consumed with our flesh, the things we want instead of what God wants. And when it gets to the end and that emergency arrives, that future comes, he's called you out of this world unprepared. Because you didn't make plans for the future. And he'll say, depart from me, ye workers of iniquity. I never knew you. You never made plans to live with me eternally. You never asked me to be a part of your life. You consumed all that I entrusted you with for your own desires. Therefore, depart from me, ye workers of iniquity. I don't want to hear him say that to you. I want to plan for the future. I want him to know that he is my Lord. And I'll take the 90 and I'll plan for what God will have me to do. And I'll make do with the 90, but I'll never touch his. It belongs to him. I know where all of this comes from. And if I honor him and plan for the future and use this wisely, he'll bless me with more than what I need. My cup runneth over, David said. The Lord bless me beyond measures to bless others. Amen? To bless others. Today is a great day to get our stewardship in check. It's a great day. We start using excuses, we'll lose. But if you start making plans, amen, we'll win. We'll win. You can't walk with God in closing. You can't walk without God without becoming a giver. You know why? Because God gave. God became a servant and gave to us. He gave us all. He gave us all. 100% of him. When he died on the cross, what does the Bible say in John 3:16? For God so loved, he gave his only begotten Son. That whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. Isn't that all? That's all. Amen. He gave us all. We should give our all to him. He owns all of it. It all belongs to him. I'm just thankful he lets me use a little bit of it. For the time being, somebody else, like I said earlier, somebody else is going to enjoy it after I'm gone, hopefully. But I hope they honor God with it. Thank God for it. Amen. Thank God for it. Because God gave it to me because he's a giver and we should be a giver too. And when you really think about it, using our time, our talent, our testimony, and our treasure really isn't given at all. It's just returning what belongs to the master, the property owner. Amen? It's just returning to what the property owner owns. He owns it all. I disagree with you, preacher. I know some people are thinking this. I disagree with you. I work for that. You really? Did you really work? I mean, who gave you the strength to get up out of the bed to go to work? I slaved over that. I did this and I did that. You done nothing unless God allowed you to do it. Remember, he breathed the breath of life into man. Man became a living soul after that. Man didn't become a living soul before that. Man can't survive on his own. If they could, we wouldn't see a graveyard. Hello? We wouldn't see a graveyard. We can't survive on our own. We need God. And it's because of him we're able to get up out of that bed, put our shoes on, and go down there and punch a clock and make the money. Hello? And if it wasn't for him, we wouldn't be there. We wouldn't be there. Thank God. Amen. It all belongs to him. You didn't do a thing that God didn't allow you to do. It's all because of him. And it's because of him I shared this message with you today. Because it all belongs to him. It all belongs to him. Your time, your talent, your treasure, and your testimony. It all belongs to him. Don't give him the core. Give him the first fruit. Adam and Eve messed up, didn't they? They had it made. All they had to do was take care of everything else and stay away from the tree of knowledge of good and evil. And they couldn't even do that because Satan blinded them to all the blessings that God bestowed upon them. They had eternal life. Death had never came into the world at that point until they disobeyed. Until they disobeyed. And then they were stripped of all the good things God wanted to bless them with. I don't know about you, but I don't think I stick to God's plan. How about you? Let us stand. Our Heavenly Father, God, as we come to you today, Lord, we are grateful and thankful, Lord, for the words that we've heard today.